All right, everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I have Grant Thompson here, the King of Random, and today is World Toilet Day, so we thought we'd do a collab video using some toilets. So this is gonna be a continuation of my quest to flush things down a toilet that I probably shouldn't. Last time I did mercury, Grant just did sodium, and today I'm gonna do liquid nitrogen.
We just filmed a video flushing sodium metal down a toilet on my channel, so if you wanna know what happens when you flush sodium down a toilet, go check it out.
Link will be down in the description and probably up on the screen here. Go. Toilet's loaded. Got some nitrogen.
Frosty.
So we're gonna start small. You can see the toilet's filled with water. We're gonna see if we can flush a cup of nitrogen down it. Here we go. Can't really see much in there. Here we go, we're gonna flush it. Whoa. Oh, that's cool.
Bro, we get it, you vape.
You know what? Here, hold this for a second.
Just don't make vapor. You can put your face in it.
How much is down in the bucket? It looks like all the nitrogen got boiled away. It is kind of warm water. Let's try again with a little bit more nitrogen.
It's a little hard to see because of the lighting, but there's a little bit of residue left in there. You can see where it's turned the water into ice.
Oh, it is ice. Look at that. It's like a little piece of ice.
Yeah, you should chew on that.
Okay.
Cody Wood.
It's a brand new toilet.
That's right. This is a fresh out of the box toilet, so never been used yet. All right, we're stepping it up to the next level. We got our thermos here. We're going to pour in about a third of this and see how that does. So.
Okay.
Nice. Ooh, that's some good stuff. Check that out.
All right, ready for flushing?
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, that's lovely. It like followed me up. There's more nitrogen
in here. Hey, get down here, man. We got to do this selfie style. Get down there.
All right. Ready?
Three, two.
It's actually still got nitrogen in here. So, the toilet can't flush the nitrogen because the nitrogen is less dense than water. You can see it actually floating on top of the water in my hand.
So this time we're gonna test the theory. If nitrogen stays on the water the entire time, I'm gonna look under the toilet here to see if we capture anything coming through.
Alright. We're gonna pour a bunch more in.
Nitro toilet. Love it.
270 below zero.
Alright, check it out.
Alright, I'm ready to flush.
Ready. Oh, we got a little bit, There's not much though, and it's gone just as fast as it came. Yeah, it definitely looks a lot different than this does up here. You pulling ice out of there?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's all crusted up with ice, that's crazy.
Yeah, I actually just broke my glove. So I say what we do next is take all the water out and see if we can flush it with nitrogen instead of with water. There's the nitrogen coming out.
Check this out, check this out. Look at the layer of ice that's built up here. It's almost completely covering the escape hatch there. That's all ice. Doesn't last very long though, but that's crazy.
And that was warm water.
Probably want to lift it back up.
That's a little
bit. That's happened to me many times renovating houses. Tip the toilet over and you get all the brown water.
Oh.
Here we go.
There it is, I can't see anything.
Oh, you can hear it cracking?
Something's breaking in there.
Yeah, that's that rubber stopper, I think. The question is it coming down into the bowl?
I can't see it.
It's kind of hard to tell. It's just like a massive cloud right now.
Alright, let's finish it off.
It sounds like Rice Krispies, snap, crackle, pop. Hold on 1 second, I'm gonna get you doing that.
Alright.
It is crackling and popping. We think the rubber stopper's probably letting go. So Cody's filling up the tank and we're just gonna see if we can get this thing flushed off before it totally breaks down.
Okay.
It's hard to tell if it's leaking into the bowl or not. There's a lot of... Oh my gosh, that's amazing. And Cody's getting asphyxiated.
It's actually going down into the bottom.
Yeah, I think it's bypassing the rubber and it's going straight into the toilet.
It's cracking the toilet.
Where are we seeing that?
I'm hearing the ceramic cracking.
I actually hear it too. Do you have any more nitrogen?
I got a little bit more.
Now would be the time to pour it. Like that did anything. That's amazing.
Yeah, that's it too then.
All right, we're adding the rest of the nitrogen. My shadow's in the way. We can hear the ceramic cracking. The rubber stopper is completely let go.
Okay, the flusher opened up. Let the nitrogen through, but it was going through already.
That's crazy.
This is frozen to the ground. Yeah. There's our nitrogen right there.
Oh, waste not, want not.
Let's pour it back into the bucket.
I want to see that whole bowl let go. Do you think it's cold enough you could just like hit it with a hammer? Or...
Probably. Nitrogen back in. And it's just going straight through now.
Straight through. Yep. So the flushing mechanism does nothing.
The flushing mechanism does activate, but the nitrogen just goes straight through.
And that's because this rubber stopper probably.
Yeah, rubber stoppers.
You could probably take that out and crush it in your hand, honestly.
Let's see. Yep, look at that.
Yeah, that's very brittle.
The chain seems to be doing all right.
What's amazing is I don't actually see any cracks on the toilet yet. Oh, actually, there is a big crack down here.
Yeah, I heard it cracking.
There we go. You can see some cracking here in the toilet and the porcelain. This is where the nitrogen is sitting at the bottom of the bowl. And it's super cold. We got condensation on the outside of the bowl here.
Yeah, you got a little bit of Leidenfrost effect there. The toilet's still hot, even though it's parts of it are cooled down to the nitrogen temperatures. The dissimilar cooling rates is why it's cracking.
Yeah, it's too bad we didn't get that thing to bust open though. That's a pretty significant crack right there. Look at the imprint that made on the ground there, underneath the bucket.
It's frozen.
You can see the flush handle is like completely covered in frost. This is moisture from the air that's frozen under the metal. Cody's just breaking plastic like it's pieces of plastic. Woo! Oh yeah, just like totally... Froze. Yeah. Whoa, dang it! It just grew. It froze my glove solid in an instant. That's amazing. Yeah, why do we wear gloves? This serves no purpose whatsoever.
It rolls off the glove, usually.
Yeah, supposed to.
Now it's surprising that the mercury actually didn't damage the toilet as much as the nitrogen did.
That's true. And how heavy was that mercury?
I think I had 240 pounds in it.
And how much do you think the nitrogen was?
This, I think, would put 3 gallons of nitrogen through there.
So quick math on that, about 15 pounds? I don't know. That's what it felt like. Yeah, interesting. You know what we should do now is throw some water in there with that nitrogen and just watch it react. All right, we got a thermos full of lukewarm water. We're just gonna see what happens when that hits.
You just dump it in there.
Right in the tank here or right in the bowl?
Probably the tank.
Yeah, here we go.
Oh, that was a money shot.
Woohoo!
It's actually cracking it worse.
You're right. Why don't you shock it one more time? Throw some nitrogen in that bowl, and then when it gets cold enough, then give it a good swift kick. Uh-oh. This is what I love, is how it skittles around on the ground. There we go. Beautiful, look at that.
All right, you ready to swift kick it?
Success!
Broke it. I feel like this is actually cracked up in here too. So you can actually see where the water actually channels down into the base of the bowl. And it flows out through this little hole here. That's to give the stuff that you put in the toilet a little extra kick to get it to go up this tube.
And all the rest of your debris comes down this tube.
Let's go up this tube and then down there into the septic system. Except that I don't have it hooked to a septic system.
And the purpose of this loop here is to create a water lock to prevent smelly gases from getting up into your house.
Yeah, which is a good thing because smelly and possibly explosive methane.
Yeah, not to mention like snakes or rats or anything else that you don't want getting into your house from the sewers.
Oh, rats still get up in there.
It looks like a little face there.
Where?
Hello, toilet. He's got like two eyes and a little funny mouth there. Oh, and then we got like two arms sticking out. Looks like something out of Minecraft.
What an
elephant almost. Look at that. What the heck? Okay, it's time to go.
Over on Grant's channel, we flushed some solid sodium down a toilet. And if you want to go see what that does, go over to his channel. I'll put a link in the description and somewhere up here.
It's quite the reaction. You don't want to miss it, so come check it out.
Hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.